the bottom side of the canopy is made out of limestone, and limestone forms in layers. A good example of a layer is this guy back here. Now, back when we were filled with water hundreds of millions of years ago, water would get in between these layers of limestone and builds up enough.
Alright,
guys, you're gonna get to your left, please. From catwalk area
kind of thing.
Somebody stop talking. This is my job.
How many times
did they do this? This is my fourth time. Yeah. Usually, usually, about 3 minutes after here. But, you know. Same old, same old. So, this is our stage a little bit to your right. We do have concerts and private events.
Yeah, it's okay. Running mashed potatoes.
Snot. Light your green out, guys, okay?
Okay.
3, 2, 1. Whoa! I'll see you guys in 2 weeks.
The room in which you are now seated is approximately 1/2 mile from the entrance and nearly 300 feet beneath the surface of the mountain. You have just crossed the hall of the mountain cave, the largest room in the cave.
Where are you? Why are you here in the darkness? What has driven you to be here at this place, deep under the majestic mountain? You could have gone anywhere today, but you ended up here. Why? By going under the sea or into the void of space, man was not made to live in these conditions. Into a hostile environment, into the darkness. Where are you? Why are you here? To seek adventure. It's in your blood. You're drawn to it. The first adventurer to bring light into this place is Aaron Higginbottom, who was 1810. He left his wife Lizzie at home, and unknown to Aaron, she was carrying his unborn son. So fragile was Aaron's light source that he could not stay away. Something he found in his adventures drew him further, over and over. Oh, he'd seen other caves, but this one had such a grand scale over all the others. He loved his adventure. The little discoveries gave him a tickle of joy. The delicate little soda straws, twisted helictites, the giant domes, the huge rooms, galleries going on for miles, the twists and the turns. Finally it happened. A slip, his light went out. His attempts to relight the torch ended with nervous crumblings, and those pieces too fell in a deep crevasse between the boulders. His entire world suddenly consisted of the top of one large rock. He carefully scouted the edges as far as he could reach, but he feared taking a leap across in the darkness, not knowing the width of the chasm before the next boulder, and how many boulders to hop until he'd get to an exit. There were far too many, and he knew it. His fear became despair and gripped him to the bone. He feared no one would look for him in so deep an unknown cave. He pondered his life. He wondered, his life made a difference in the world? What would you do? What would you think about? Would you pray? Aaron sure did.
Lord, I say that you're the light of the world, and I'm in a place of such darkness. I need your help. I'm such fear.
With no way to measure time, Aaron didn't know if it had been minutes, hours, or days. Then something unexpected. Aaron made a choice to put his fear away, for it did not serve him well. He would no longer dwell on the despair. He would conjure up hope. For the next several hours, he would focus on the great, the wondrous things that he had experienced in his adventures. He would recall those moments of joy that he had felt here as he discovered these things. In his mind, he could imagine them in vivid detail, and his joy grew from a sheer will. In his mind, he chose to hear music that was positive and uplifting. After what seemed like months, Aaron heard the sound of his friends and saw the flickering lights of their torches. It had been 3 days. His friends had found his knapsack outside, by the mouth of the great cave, and they knew of his adventures in spirit. Aaron's coal black hair had turned to snow white, but he was joyful to be rescued. What would you have done? You are the explorer today. Will you cherish these discoveries? Enjoy the rest of your adventure here in Cumberland Caverns.
This is her room.
This is your house?
This is my home. I'm a patron. Refreshments.
What?
This is your house and
you don't have food?
No, I have food. I eat pizza. And patrons. Patrons on pizza.
No. Will you help?
I don't know how to help you.
Not when you live in a cave.
It's a dog.
So we're going to continue down, guys. It does get steep, so please
do not have it. No, the one
you're fighting. For situations like this, where you guys are here, absolutely sorry.
I know, I wish I would have got that shirt that says Into the Darkness Now.
Uh-huh. kick the dust, Darian. You made it, guys.
Freedom, guys.
We made it out. Thank you.
Thanks, guys. So, gift shop is closed, but you're going to go behind the gift shop and see a building that is our outside restrooms if you guys need
them. All right.
Well, we don't know. I think we might be going towards Nashville.
I know.
Nice.